Number three, what do you do when it seems that God has moved? Believe the promise of God. Tell three people, believe the promise. Believe the promise. The promise was that the children of Israel shall go on dry ground through the midst of the sea. And if God said it, God is going to do it. If God said you're going to make it, you're going to make it. He that hath begun a good work in you shall perform it until the day of the Lord Jesus Christ. Speak unto them that they go forward. Look at your neighbor and say, go forward. When God moves, understand that a miraculous process is just as much a miracle as a miraculous event. Would you say that after me? A miraculous process is just as much a miracle as is a miraculous event. Our problem is we don't like processes. Look at your neighbor and say, your problem is you don't like processes. We want instantaneous events. We want God to do the thing right now. Hallelujah. But for Israel, God didn't give them a miraculous event. He gave them a miraculous process. First, the wind began to blow. And the water backed up. And then the wind began to blow again. And the ground began to dry up. And then God held the water back. And the children of Israel were able to go across. But then God brought the water back to its place again. When the Egyptians tried to use God's highway, and the Israelites had to wait all night long. While God was doing the work, God, they had to wait all night long. While God had them in the midst of a miraculous process. When you get a miraculous event, it's a snap of the finger and a praise of the Lord. But when you get a miraculous process, you've got to learn how to wait on God. Got to learn how to trust Him. He may not come when you want it, but He'll be right on time. Will you tell somebody, hold on? They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They will mount up on wings like eagles. They'll run and not be weary. They'll walk and not faint. Will you tell somebody, hold on, child of God. Hold on, child of God. It's going to be all right. I know we've lost a leader, but we have not lost our God. I know we've lost a bishop, but God is still alive. He's not just in front of you. He's not just behind you, but He's all around you. For the angel of the Lord encamps round about them that fear Him. The Lord said, I fill both heaven and earth, and I'm with you even unto the end of the age. And so I've heard the lightning, I've seen the lightning flashing, and I've heard the thunder roll, and I've felt sin's breakers dashing, trying to conquer my soul. But I heard the voice of my Savior telling me still to fight on. He promised never to leave me, never to leave me alone. No, never alone. No, never alone. Would you raise that hand and say, no, never alone. He's everywhere, and He's everywhere powerful. And if He's everywhere and everywhere powerful, it's going to be all right. I said it's going to be all right. All right. Tell your neighbor, all right. Tell your neighbor, all right. Get up and give God praise. Come on and praise Him. Come on and praise Him. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the life of this bishop. Thank you, Lord, for his wonderful career. Thank you, Lord, for the service he gave. Thank with us for almost 80 years. Thank you, Lord, for every sermon he preached. Thank you, Lord, for the life he lived. Thank you. Hallelujah. You're not through with us yet. Our best days are still ahead. So hold on, child of God. Hold on, woman of God. Hold on, man of God. It's going to be all right. Will you raise your hand and say, all right? Say it again, all right. One more time, all right. Come on, praise him.
Rejoicing now.